Hey there, I'm Mallory with Babylist Scout. Today I am here to talk about different types of baby monitors and the features to consider. First things first, know that your baby monitor is majorly dependent on what your family needs. So let's talk about options. There are three major types of baby monitors: audio, video, and what I like to call smart. Audio baby monitors only let you hear baby. This is the most budget-friendly because there aren't a whole lot of bells and whistles to baby's first walkie-talkie. The things you could spend a little bit more on with audio-only monitors are these things. Long range, so you can be further away from baby's room but still hear them, and being able to hear baby clearly with no static or fuzz. These monitors win on the budget-friendly and portability categories for sure. But if you're craving the visual, it's a no-go. A popular pick for the audio-only monitors is the VTech DM221 audio baby monitor. It costs around $35, which is way cheap, and parents say the audio transmission is nice and clear with no crackle. There's also a two-way audio, which means you can talk back to baby. That's a really nice feature on any type of monitor. This one also has a visual indicator that alerts you when there are cries from the other room, even if you have your volume turned down. And on to video baby monitors. This is definitely the most popular baby monitor types these days. And now there are two video monitor types: non-Wi-Fi monitors, which have an external monitor for you to view baby while you're in your home, and Wi-Fi monitors, which allow you to access the video feed from an app on your phone from anywhere and everywhere that has internet. Non-Wi-Fi monitors limit you to your house because of the local connection. They use either an available radio frequency or an encrypted digital signal that transmits and receives audio video in discrete numbers. There's no Wi-Fi or Bluetooth involved. And some parents feel this is a little bit more of a secure connection, because even if someone else is using a device on the same frequency as your baby monitor, they can't easily hear and see what your baby monitor is transmitting. A non-Wi-Fi monitor does use a battery-powered handheld device to help you see baby's room, and the quality of the picture is pretty clear up to a certain range before losing connection. Here's what to look for when choosing the best handheld monitor to view baby with. A clearer and bigger picture. 5 inches is considered extra large, while 3.5 is more average. You'll want lots of range. Longer ranges are more expensive, and the max is about 1,000 feet. Solid battery life is key, like more than 8 hours, because these handheld devices do need to be charged, and if you're charging all the time, that can get annoying. Non-Wi-Fi baby monitors with separate handheld devices do win on the security front because of its local connection, but do keep in mind you will have a limited range and battery life. A popular pick for a non-Wi-Fi video baby monitor is the Infant Optics DXR8 video baby monitor. It costs around $165 and comes with a 3.5-inch display screen that parents say has a very impressive video picture because of the self-contained camera lens system. Parents also love that there's very little delay in the video feed. You have the ability to adjust and pan, tilt, and zoom remotely, which means you don't have to go into baby's room to make the tweaks and risk waking them. Another major win. And you get great features like two-way audio and room temperature tracking with this monitor as well. The other type of video baby monitor is the Wi-Fi one. These don't only let you see baby when you're at home, but also when you leave the house. And you can usually access the video from an app on your phone or whatever device you're using, so you won't need a separate handheld device. As long as the baby monitor and your phone or whatever device you're viewing with are connected to Wi-Fi, you can check on baby anywhere. This makes Wi-Fi monitors great nanny cams in the long run. The Wi-Fi baby monitors specifically, you can spend more on these things: a super secure connection. Most use what's called wireless encryption and firmware to protect your video feed and make it as close to unhackable as possible. A solid Wi-Fi connection with no delay. 2.4 gigahertz is typically the speed required for a clear connection. Video history is another factor here. Since this type of monitor connects to an app, some allow you to access access video history from a few days to months, and maybe even to share clips with friends, but you will probably need to pay a subscription fee for that. It's definitely cool to be able to access Baby from anywhere with Wi-Fi monitors, and the fact that they can act as a nanny cam down the line is handy. But the Wi-Fi struggles for streaming and security concerns are real. A popular pick for a Wi-Fi video baby monitor is the Nest Cam. At around $200, this monitor is super loved by parents for its crisp 1080p picture quality day and night on any device from anywhere. There are so many ways to mount this camera, so you can get optimal views as baby grows, and you can zoom in from the app too. Some love the app connection of this monitor and Wi-Fi monitors in general, while others have been left craving for a separate handheld monitor because you can't be on Instagram and see your baby at the same time. And when grandma comes over and wants to sneak a peek at your sleeping baby, you don't have to give her your phone. Last video type for you guys. Are you ready for this? Smart baby monitors. These monitors go way past just hearing and seeing baby. These ones actually take on things like baby's sleep and breathing and reporting it to you with alerts and analytics. These monitors can get pricey depending on what you want to monitor, and sometimes you may have to have baby wear something to get the readings. Now, with all the different types of smart monitors, these are the things to keep an eye out for nearly all of them. Accurate alerts, whether the device is beeping at you, flashing lights, or sending a notification to your phone, ensuring that the alerts are accurate is key. Faulty alerts can cause more stress than they're worth. Placement. Know that some devices need to be worn on the baby, so you might only get to use it when baby isn't super wiggly. Others must be mounted above the crib, so if you don't even own one, then this isn't a good fit. The placement of smart monitors feels very much more specific than the others do, where you can just set it on a nightstand. Just be sure that you do know and understand what you're signing up for. And subscriptions. With smart monitors comes access to smart data, but not all the data is free. Know that a lot of smart monitors do require a monthly or annual subscription to get its great insights, usually after a brief free trial. These smarty pants monitors do get brownie points for innovation, but the price and added cost of the subscriptions, restrictions and placements, and the possibility of faulty alerts are big considerations. A few popular picks for the smart monitors are these. The Snooze Hero costs around $100 and clips to baby's diaper and alerts with beeps if their breathing is weak. The Cocoon Cam is about $130 and also monitors baby's breathing, but without a wearable. This Wi-Fi video monitor gives you a bird's eye view of baby's crib and shows you breathing patterns in the app. The Nanit Cam goes for $279 and monitors baby's sleep habits. With a subscription, you can access valuable sleep data based on each night's snooze. The Owlet Smart Sock 2 runs for $300. It tracks baby's heart rate and oxygen levels with a wearable sock while baby sleeps and alerts you in an app and on the included base station with light sounds if something is out of range. Paired with a Wi-Fi video baby monitor, this bundle is $400. And that's all I have for you guys today. Baby Monitors 101 is done. I hope this has been helpful, and let us know in the comments if you have any other types of baby monitor questions. Also, be sure to check out Babylist Gear Guides for more great info like this, and happy registering!